Well, again, students, a very good morning to you. And yesterday we have studied about nouns. I hope you have learned all the definitions of all kinds of nouns. And now today I'm going to teach you about pronouns. What are pronouns? The next step, nouns and pronouns are the parts of a speech. Let me tell you. Parts of speech, very important. There are total 8 parts. The first one is noun, second one is pronouns, third one is verb, then comes adjectives, fifth one is adverb, sixth one is prepositions, the seventh one is conjunctions, and the eighth one is interjections. We'll cover it all. It is in your syllabus. Nouns we have already covered. We'll do the exercise later. Today's topic is pronouns. So what are pronouns? Let me teach you here. Today's topic is pronouns and their types. Let me begin with the definition of the pronouns. Pronouns are the words which we use at the place of nouns. Very clear? Let me give you an example. Suppose here I write, there lives a lion in the jungle. So here if I see, then lion is a noun here. Now if I write to one more sentence related to this, it was very powerful. So when I write it, it is my pronoun here. Why? When I am saying there lives a lion in the jungle, so lion, and when I read the second line, it was very powerful. So it, what it means here, it means this lion. So when I am using a word, when I am using pronoun at the place of the noun, again and again I can write like this also, lion was very powerful. So instead of not to repeat the noun word again and again in the sentence, I use pronoun instead of the noun. That is the basic work of the pronouns. Now after this we'll study about the types of the pronouns. The very first one which goes here is personal pronouns. What are the personal pronouns? Let me give you an idea. Personal pronouns are used as a substitute to identify a particular person. To identify a particular person or place name. For example, what are these? Let me give you a pronoun table. We also use it as object sometimes. I and we as the first person. You as in the second person. And he, she, it, and they as the third person. Very clear here. So sometimes I use it as object also. This is subjective, or grammatically I can also write nominative. When I use it, all these persons in the objective form. When I say objective, I also called it as accusative. So, I becomes mine. We becomes our. You becomes you. He becomes him. She becomes her. It becomes it. And they becomes them. You can see it. That is subjective. When I use personal pronouns at the place of the subject in the sentence, I use these pronouns as personal pronouns. For example, I am saying my name is Prateek Sharma. So instead of Prateek Sharma, I can use I, or all the students are getting the class. When students will speak, they can use we. Now the next thing is, that is you becomes you, he, she, it, and they. For example, for masculine gender, I use he. For feminine, she. It for the things of the neutral gender. And they, commonly we call for the group of people. Now, let's jump upon to the next type of pronouns. Let me tell you what these pronouns are. Quickly, I am telling you it. Next pronouns are the possessive pronouns. Possessive pronouns, as the name suggests, are the pronouns which shows the ownership. Or possession. By ownership or possession, what I meant that yes, it is under my possession, it is mine. So these are my, our, your, his, her, its, and there. These are the possessive pronouns. Now I will tell you the next kind of pronoun, which are relative pronouns. Relative pronouns are the pronouns which relate noun or pronoun to the other part of the sentence. how what they are first tell you first let me tell you these are myself yourself himself herself itself ourselves and themselves. I've used here self and here selves, reason being these are the plural forms. How I use it, if I give you an example, you will quickly understand it. What it is, if I say I will do my work myself. So here I is a pronoun as well as myself is also a pronoun, but if you see the meaning of it, these both are same. I means I and myself also means I here. So myself and I, these both are same. It relate that who will do my work? Myself. I will do my work myself. So this is the relation and it relates one part of the sentence to another part. Now we'll talk about next kind of pronouns, and the next kind of pronouns are interrogative pronouns. As the name suggests, interrogative sentences are the sentences which are used to ask questions, and interrogative pronouns are used to ask questions. What these are? These are who, why, whom, etc. So whenever I use the pronoun that who will do the work, who will do the work, I'm asking a question here, and this particular who is the interrogative pronoun. Now I will teach you our next kind of pronoun, and next kind of pronoun is demonstrative pronouns. Demonstrative pronouns. What these are? These pronouns are used to point out a noun which has already been mentioned. What these are? This, that, these, those. This plural, these, that plural, those. These are the demonstrative pronouns which are used to point out that I want this book, or I want this marker. Which marker? This marker. So this I use for the things which are near to my hand, and that I use for the things which are far away from me. For example, on a table 3 books are lying. If I want this book, this book. So this which is near to my hand, and if something is there at a distance, so where I cannot reach, I will say that house or that book which is in the shelf, that red book. So that we use for the things which are far away from us, and this we use for the things which are near to us. Similarly, plural, these and those work for the distance and for the near places. Now we'll tell you our last kind of pronoun, We have two names for it. One is intensive and another one is emphatic. Intensive or emphatic pronouns. What it is? Are used to give emphasize. I mean when I give something pressure to something, or when I give particularly force to something. How? In the example you will understand. I myself will wash my clothes. And here one more sentence I am writing. I will wash my clothes. So both the sentence mean same, that who will wash the clothes? I will wash the clothes. But I myself will wash the clothes, it gives emphasizing, it emphasizes the pronoun I. That is, who will do? I myself, and here only I. So the pronouns which are used to give emphasis are called the emphatic or intensive pronouns. That is all about the kinds of pronouns. Today we have studied different kind of pronouns and what are pronouns. Practice it in your grammar book or in any of the book which is written in English, any subject book which is written in English. If you study it, try to point out the pronouns with your pencil and try to find out that what kind of pronoun it is. It will be a good practice for you. Today's homework is this only, that you will take any of the book which is written in English, any subject, it could be SST or maths or science, and when anything is written with your pencil, encircle that pronoun and over that pronoun write that what kind of pronoun it is. Is it relative? Is it emphatic? Is it personal pronoun? Is it possessive pronoun or any other pronoun? That is all for the today's class, and I hope you all are healthy and safe at your home. Be healthy, be safe. Thanks a lot.